And now we have Ma Deborah.
Nityanandama.
Nityanandama.
Nityanandama. I'm not hearing you, Ma.
Nityanandama, can you hear me now?
I can hear you now, Ma. That's great.
Nityanandama, welcome. Great. Great to have you here, Ma. Can you just share a little bit about yourself and your background?
Yes, I'm from Toronto, Canada. I know Ma Gayatri, and I become Apat Sanyas about a couple years ago, a year and a half ago. And until I went to the Adinam, I actually, even now, I've never met Swamiji in person either. But
wow, two people.
He is incredible, and he is I will be with Swamiji forever. So yes, I'm very, very thankful for Swamiji, for the Sangha, for Sanatana Hindu Dharma. It is everything I've been searching for my entire life. and knew it existed, somehow knew it existed, but could not find it until he was right in front of me on the internet, and after calling out for him. So I took everything online I could. I even took the first six seasons of Parama Shivoham. And that's when I declared Apat Sanyas.
Wow.
And I'm so, so, so blessed. So much has changed. He has healed me so much. I can't even, it's not just healed me, but healed my life, healed my relationships, healed in every aspect, totally transformed. People who have known me in the past, they don't even recognize my body, let alone me. So he's transformed me greatly, and I'm so thankful, so thankful.
Wow. Yes.
Wow. What I just thought
so
of.
So can you share a little bit, Ma?
Yes, go ahead.
About what exactly you, what feeling you've experienced. Sorry, Ma, I didn't mean to interrupt. I was just asking, can you elaborate a little bit more about your background and your experiences with Swamiji, about how, what kind of healing you've experienced, and how you, in every possible way.
Mm-hmm. Well, I grew up with, my childhood was filled with a lot of abuse, and I thought I had gotten away with it, got away from it and moved beyond that when I went to university, but, it still affected all my relationships, men and women, all relationships, all types of relationships. And then finally, when I was married, I realized that later on in the relationship that I had married someone that was maybe the culmination of all those negative relationships. And so there was a lot of wrong cognitions that I didn't even realize that I was operating with. And I had created a lot of pain patterns, a lot of pain shafts, suffering, and it affected my ability to manifest, my ability to even have consistent energy or consistent resources. Sometimes I had wealth, and sometimes I ended up in poverty again. So I knew there was something not right. But as soon as I found Swamiji and Sanatana Hindu Dharma and the ecosystem of Kailasa that protected me and strengthened me, then I started really having mature conversations with myself. And Swamiji really transformed everything. I began I became Davy again. I had gone through a lot and I had sort of lost all that feminine side, the Davy side, even though I was a mother and I had felt I was a good mother. There were things I could not control and things that I magnetized to me or manifested because of what I was holding within my inner space.
So can you elaborate a little bit specifically on those experiences that where Swamiji has healed you and attended to you?
Yes. I realized not too long ago that what it really felt like to have an healed inner space, a healed heart, and melting down and clearing out all the pain shafts, pain and suffering shafts, because I was in a way doing it to myself, of course, but I was really blocked in terms of seeing how I was manifesting what I didn't want versus what I did want. So once I began having powerful cognitions and operating from conscious decision and conscious awareness in every moment, which I actually really became strong in from unclutching, doing the unclutching meditation, doing all the clutching satsangs and all that. But at first it was hard for me to even cognize unclutching. But when you unclutch or detach from all the thoughts, they don't control you anymore. You clear the inner space and then you can create, manifest what you do want in the inner space through the powerfulness of the oneness with Swamiji. Because if all those pain patterns and pain shafts are there, that's blocking you from being in full oneness with Swamiji. And Once that happened, I really started manifesting. I asked Swamiji to bless me with manifesting my reality auspiciously at will and others' reality auspiciously at will. And he said tatastu. And then I actually started doing that. And the first few times I thought, oh, did that just happen? And then it became more and more constant, more and more consistent, more and more just being in the space of oneness and causing, enriching, doing everything for Swamiji and Kilasa and Sanatana Hindu Dharma really facilitated that. So as I was manifesting my reality at will, I was also, especially you have the mirroring neurons too. So if you're in that space and you're powerfully manifesting through conscious decision, not, just going with the flow and being swung this way and that way by all your negative thoughts here and there and emotions and whatnot. Positive possibility.
You're sharing a lot about, your, yes, Mom. So you've been sharing a lot about your experiences and how you've experienced healing. How do you think that, other women in your situation who have, experienced violence or trauma in their life, why do you think they need to connect to Swamiji? Why do you feel that they could, especially in a time like this, when so much of suffering and so much of loss is there in the world, why do you think that Swamiji is needed for humanity right now?
Kalpataru and completion and unclutching, they all work together to undo the programming of the matrix world, the Maya. I didn't realize how I was programmed to, you know, just give myself over, give my energy over, give my resources over, give my the control of my reality over. And once that block was cleared, I just kept facing everything that Swamiji brought in front of me to have healed and cleared. Never give up. Don't run away. Don't shut down. But I just dropped all my fear and anxiety and uncertainty at Swamiji's feet, and just strongly, in a mature way, faced every single thing that was brought for me to clear and heal and complete. Because absolutely, the benefit is Swamiji, Paramashiva, Parashakti, completes all incompletions, past, present, and future, and negative side effects. So you can create your new reality.
Absolutely.
So you can live that new reality.
Absolutely. And what would you say to all the viewers out there, you know, especially women who might have been in your situation who have experienced, you know, similar situations as you? What would you say to them now who are listening? How would you, what kind of guidance or advice might you give them in their situation?
Don't give up and be strong to face what you need to face.
And how do you think that Swamiji would be able to help them in their situations? How he's helped you? How would you tell people to connect to Swamiji? How would you tell them about Swamiji's blessings and how they can be helped by Swamiji?
Well, there's so much. Where do I even start? The oneness capsules made a big difference for me. It's instantaneous. And the clearing of the karmas. I did the Nishakshara Shanti Homa at Houston and had a big, incredible shift after that. The pujas, giving gratitude, all the things that Swamiji provides. If you just go through the process and stick to it and don't give up, you will transform. You will receive all the blessings, all the healings, all the boons. In fact, I recently was blessed with a Akashic reading by Devi Parashanti. Mm-hmm. And it was maybe like 2 weeks ago. And all of a sudden on Friday, I had received a couple little boons since then, but I received a big one on Friday. One of the boons that Devi Parashakti blessed me for happened on Friday.
Wow,
and everything that day was very auspicious. And I just kept being in oneness with Swamiji and making positive declaration and prayers for blessing as I went through each stage throughout the day to make it happen.
And how does it make you feel, Ma, when you're seeing, you know, Swamiji not just attending to you, but attending to every single being, every single person who is in need of a blessing or healing or a boon, or, you know, even just a place to quarantine? How does it make you feel seeing Swamiji attending to every single person, you know, through the Akashic readings, through, you know, opening up the Adhinams? How does it make you feel, Ma?
It's incredible. He makes himself many, and that he's with everyone all at the same time, different degrees, different levels, according to whatever is needed. But it is a real blessing. Even those that are yet to be in oneness with Swamiji, causing enriching them as well. just giving everything that's needed so that humanity can break through this bondage and receive, enlightenment.
Absolutely. Which
was meant to occur long ago, but it's incredible that Swamiji is sacrificing everything to make sure we are all that want to be, want to rise up out of the Maya and to be enlightened are in that process of receiving that.
Absolutely. And you know, it's like so beautiful to hear your sharing and how you've experienced Swamiji and how he's attended to you exactly how you needed at that time. You know, every single person, maybe they might not even be interested in spirituality, but how Swamiji is attending exactly every single aspect of their life, every single thing that they need. It's such a beautiful experience, like, to hear about, especially, you know, hearing from you from where you came from and to where you are now, you know, taking up at Sannyas and, you know, deciding to commit your life to Sangha and Swamiji. It's such a beautiful sharing that you've given us today.
Thank you, Ma. I really appreciate it. Thank you all, everyone does in facilitating Swamiji's mission for humanity, for the earth, for the universe, for the cosmos. It is a real blessing. Thank you, Ma, with great gratitude.
Thank you so much for your time, Ma. Thank you. Okay. So we will be right back after a short break. Thank you.